All right, here at Franklin High School with head football coach Ian Bain, Panthers beat Wachusett 37-21. Coach Bain, congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Good to see you first things first.
Yeah.
Obviously, big story tonight was the big play. You guys hit three big plays on him. They come down, they score early, go up 7-0. You guys didn't get rattled at all. You come back, score. But talk about offensively. Talk about what was there for you guys tonight that enabled you to hit some of those big plays.
Yeah, well, I thought we had a pretty good plan with how we were going to get our run game going. And then, you know, obviously teams are going to adjust, so you got to protect your run. And we hit two of those big plays were play actions specifically off that run game, right off that run action. There was kind of one guy that could potentially make the tackle on the run every time if we blocked it upright. And then as soon as he made the tackle, going after that area on the field. And obviously, you know, Jared did a great job selling the fake, I thought. That kid came right in the alley both times, kind of left a one-on-one, a kid thinking maybe I have help, maybe I don't, and both times he didn't. So that made a big impact there. I think when we threw the ball early, we had a couple, not big plays, but kind of on the perimeter, kind of controlling the outer thirds. So as that kind of expanded, that opened up our seams. So Shane was able to get down the field on the seam route early. And then I think when you have Matt Gula, I mean, that's an equalizer for your pass game. So I think both run and pass complemented each other very well tonight.
Yeah, you mentioned Matt Gula. I mean, he runs hard, tough. He's I went to high school with his old man, yeah. So I know the family well. talk a little bit about him and him being a catalyst in your offense, because he really gets you guys going, and that sets up a lot of the stuff you can do in the passing game.
Yeah, and I think we saw a little bit of everything he could do tonight, except I don't know if he had a catch out of the backfield, but he had a couple powerful runs where he was able to run over people, make guys pay for trying to tackle him one-on-one. I think, you know, it's nice to when you try to scheme things up to be able to say, we can leave one guy unblocked because Mac's either going to make a miss or run through him, and then he's got the breakaway speed. I know it got called back, but he took a 95-yarder to the house to end the game, you know. We'll see on what it looks like on film, but you know he's got that breakaway speed too. And I think we were able to get really into our stretch game, get them kind of moving. They're very big, get them moving horizontally a little bit, and then he has great vision on top of it. So he's very smooth with his cuts. And then when we run tight zone, he's able to jump cut back and get off the table. And he did a really nice job with his run and what he had to do tonight.
Obviously, you know, before we went live, I mentioned the fact that you're playing an unbelievable schedule. You've never been afraid to play people since you've been here.
Right.
Talk about where you're at as a program right now, where you're confident in scheduling anybody to come here or that you'll go to their place.
Yeah, well, I think it's just if you want to get to a certain place, you have to challenge yourself. And I think also, you know, talking to other coaches in the league that have done the same, it sends a message to your team too, like, hey, this is what we think of you now. We think that we can play a team that was, I think they finished top 10 ranked in the state at the end of spring, their perennial top 25. And, you know, Duxbury is obviously an amazing program, Brockton, a great power traditionally, and then our normal league schedule. But I think it sends a subtle message to our team and to our future players, like, this is who we want to play. And you don't have to go outside our team, you don't have to go outside of the Hawk to get a great schedule, like some of the private schools might claim to offer. So we've got to offer that, and I think, you know, we're there, and it's obviously going to present its own set of challenges, but you know, we've never been afraid of the challenge, and if we prepare right, I think we can hang with about anybody.
Final question, just your thoughts on the new statewide playoff, and how do you manage the season before you get there, because with the tougher schedule,
yeah,
it's more of a grind, there's more wear and tear there. So your thoughts on the statewide playoff, and how do you manage the season as a head coach going into the playoffs?
Right. I mean, honestly, I wish I understood it better. I think it's a lot of I've heard this and maybe it's that, and I haven't met anybody that's like the old system, not that it was better or worse, but I definitely knew it. This one, you know, we'll see. I think the biggest thing is just focusing on what's in front of us. I think if we win all our games regardless, it's going to be good, and if we're competitive and we're playing hard and we have a good schedule, then it's going to prepare us for when we get there. In terms of managing the team, you know, especially playing basically two seasons in 1 year, you know, we're fortunate with our depth and kind of how we've developed our roster that a lot of guys are one way. Not that that's going to stay that way forever. I mean, Jonathan Martin's played a lot of both ways tonight. We have some other players that can and will too. But it's also just like we've always tried to think we want to play our best football in October and November, and we stay true to that and trust that process. I think we've always kind of done it that way, and hopefully we can keep our team, you know, through that attrition that happens to everybody.
Coach Bain, thank you for the time, my friend. Good to see you.
Awesome. Great to see you.